this by strong leadership is not physical strength, it's the ability of a leader who's held in awe and reverence, a national leader like G.P. Kurala. And I'm 100% sure that had he lived and if he was around, you would have had a constitution. He was the person, he was able, if you recall in 2008, just before the elections, the Madheshis were not coming on for the elections. They wanted Ek Pradesh, Ek Madhesh. He was able not only to get the Maoists on board, the Maoists were also not coming on board for the elections. It was he who got the Maoists as well as the Madheshis on board for the election. So his ability to strike a compromise with the leader of that party, that kind of a leader, if you look at the South Africa peace process, how did the South Africa peace process, because you had Nelson Mandela and you had a strong white leader, so it is because of they were able to, I mean the positions of the ANC and the Afrikaners were so opposed, but they were able to come to an agreement because here were two leaders and they were able to make compromises, and that compromise is not there. And I think what Ramchandra Padyal is saying, finally you may have to resort to a referendum. On this, I think the key issue is on ethnicity, whether you are going to have ethnicity-based structures, states in Nepal, and the Maoists are committed. They were committed to for the Madheshis. They wouldn't have had the Madheshi support during the revolution, and they are committed now. As a good pro quo to the Madheshis and the other Janjatis who joined. The main force of the revolution was Janjatis. How the hell are they now, the Maoists, even if intellectually they are not part of this, the ethnic identity structure, they can't get out of it now, and therefore perhaps the referendum is the only answer. But strong leadership doesn't mean muscular leadership, right? It's the ability to be able to forge a compromise.
And then, just referendum is the only answer, just
in issues pe jhagda hoga, presidential form hoga.
Maan liye 20 issues pe jhagda reh gaya.
Is pe
20 pe referendum, kya aaj ki sthiti mein Nepali aam aadmi jo hai वो इन 20 इश्यूज को समझने में सक्षम है?
वह 20 इश्यूज नहीं है मेरे ख्याल में. फॉर्म ऑफ फेडरलिज्म और दैट इज द मेन इश्यू. दैट फॉर्म या डेवोल्यूशन, यूनिट ऑफ डेवोल्यूशन एंड द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द स्टेट कैसे बनेगा.
और भी बहुत सारे ऐसे हैं जो हम लोगों को पता नहीं है, जैसे नंबर ऑफ स्टेट्स नेपाल में कितने प्रांत होंगे और उससे रिलेटेड और बहुत से दलित की स्थिति क्या होगी वहाँ पे. नोबडी इज टॉकिंग एंड दलित उसमें बहुत ज्यादा है. जो दलित एक्टिविस्ट हैं उन्होंने एक नई बात कही है, बट स्थिति यही है वहाँ के नेपाल जो हमारे दलितों की है. तो ऐसे सारे इश्यूज मेरा मतलब वो था, मान लीजिए क्या नेपाली आम जनता जो है क्या वो इन सब इश्यूज को इतनी शिक्षित है, और ये रेफरेंडम जब होगा तो क्या उस तक ये सारी चीजें पहुंच पाएंगी?
साहिर है, अगर आप जनता से पूछिए तो उनको ये भी नहीं मालूम होता है फेडरलिज्म होता क्या है, मगर फिर भी वो बोलते हैं हाँ हमें चाहिए कि कुछ चीज है जो नहीं है और अलग है, नहीं होता है पता. बट इफ यू लुक एट नाउ इवन माओवादी सर ओवर आल्सो अग्रीड दैट फॉर यू नो फॉर एथनिक कम्युनिटीज अपार्ट फ्रॉम 11 स्टेट्स दैट दे आर टॉकिंग आइडेंटिटी बेस दे आर आल्सो टॉकिंग अबाउट रिजर्व कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज आल्सो. सो यू नो बहुत और तरीके के सॉल्यूशंस भी निकल गए. आ सकते हैं या कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन लिखा जाए मेजर इश्यूज को अमेंडमेंट के थ्रू भी आप बाद में ऐड कर सकते हैं, है ना। मगर अब दो राय नहीं है कि कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन लिखना वो लिखना जरूरी है।
Tribal over there issue, but not, we are not really, our Constituent Assembly is not debating on that issue. The contentious issue is whether we go for presidential system or parliamentary system. We can have election voting on this issue. The other issue is number of federal states and naming. In fact, naming is more controversial than number at this moment. And the way out is, one group is suggesting that we'll allow the federal state themselves to name their, whatever name they want to call themselves. And there are other groups of political forces, they are saying that no, the Constituent Assembly should name them. They can have a voting on these two issues. Number is also issue, but I am more or less sure that they can compromise on number. But naming under ethnic or caste line is going to be a serious issue, and they have to vote. I am not sure whether they have to go for referendum on this, but vote. They should really use their voting right within the CA. But I would like to touch upon one of the questions, Neopanaji, Tapai, Baba, your high level visit, I would like to answer that in Nepali.
Just 1 minute.
1 minute. Amro, Esma Malaki Lakshmane, India ko banda, Amro dost, India ka junior, sana, tolla isar ka manche, aru lai nahi, Amra Pradhan Mantri, Party ka neta, Rashtrapati, Mantri, aru lai, mera kaam chalaya bachi. उनीहरूलाई फुर्सद पनि त छैन, त्यतिबाटै काम हुन्छ भने कि ठुल्ठुला मान्छे गएर समय खेर पाल्ने होइन। यो यसमा चाहिँ हाम्रो चाहिँ बोलाउने बित्तिकै फोन गर्ने बित्तिकै हातमा टोपी बोकेर कुदिहाल्ने, अनि यहाँबाट रहेका साना साना मान्छेलाई नै हाम्रा ठुल्ठुला मान्छेले भेटिदिएपछि यहाँका मान्छे काम चलाउने हो। हाम्रो देश हेर्न टुरिज्म भ्रमणको लागि जान त होइन, काम चाहिँ तलैबाट चलाउँदा हामीले चलाइदिउँ कि ठुला मान्छे जान्छ भन्ने कुरा पनि हामीले बुझ्नुपर्छ। त्यसमा चाहिँ हाम्रो दोष पढ्यो।
I know, I can see a few hands, but now, you know, we have to wind up and we leave this room. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for your participation. And you will agree with me that we've really had a very interesting discussion on Nepal and the emerging scenario in Nepal. And I thank my panelists, General Mehta, Dr. Arjun Kharki, and Shri Vijay Prakashji. Please give them a big hand. Mr. Jamal Kidwai for
I'm just doing a formal sort of vote of thanks, but thank you so much. I mean, it was a very dense and very rich discussion, and it just sort of shows that democracy is a kind of work in progress in India, given the rich ideological diversity, cultural diversity, and it will remain like that. These are all very busy people, and we were very lucky to have them here. General Mehta, Professor Kharki, Professor Kalpia, and Vijay Pratapji. Vijay Ji and Dr. Kharki are kind of in-house PSAARC members. They are sort of founders of PSAARC. And we would like, it's very heartening to see so many young people. And many of them are from Nepal, because the discussion was in Nepal. But we would request you to come for our PSAARC discussions regularly. We intend to have a series of discussions on other themes in other countries like Afghanistan and Pakistan, etc. And it would be good that you come and bring your friends and tell people about it. Thank you so much.
विचार है सोचने के लिए 19 को जब चुनाव हो जाए उसके एक दो दिन बाद
सिर्फ 22 तारीख को 21 तारीख को से रिजल्ट 21 तक आता है
हां उसके बाद हम जो भी रिजल्ट आए इरिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ द रिजल्ट क्या हम लोग जंतर मंतर पे दो दिन का फास्ट कर सकते हैं अपीलिंग टू नेपाली लीडरशिप कि वो कंसेंसस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन जल्दी दें समथिंग लाइक दैट